the Madam Monica Grigos, the First Lady, Honorable Tony Noyoma, Minister of Land Reform, Honorable Pierre Musharega, Deputy Minister of International Relations and Cooperation, Your Excellency Thomas de Harold, Mazora Ambassador of the Republic of Cuba to Namibia, Madam Zora, and the entire Cuban delegation. Honorable Steve Biko Boyce, Chairperson of the Ochozajupa Regional Council, Your Worship, the Mayors of Ochwaronga and the Otavi Councillors, Honorable Regional and Local Authority Councillors, Honorable Dr. Elia Gurale Swabo Party Youth League, Major General Thomas Lokoujo, Amira Army Commander of the Namibia Defense Force, Commissioner on Civil Security of the National Youth Service, Distinguished Veteran of the Liberation Struggle, the distinguished invited guests, members of the media, comrades and friends. I am honored and humbled to that we have gathered here at the Tunda Farm in order to receive our Cuban brothers, well known as the Cuban Five, who have traveled all the way from Cuba to show in the person of their appreciation to the Namibia government and its people for championing their release from inhuman detention by the government of the United States of America. Allow me therefore, on behalf of the Noyoma family, and indeed on my own behalf, to express my heartfelt gratitude and sincere appreciation to Cubaneros, Carlos, Renato, Adonio, Guerrero, Roman, Lobanino, Fernando, Gonzalez, and Ren Gonzalez, and indeed to the government of the Republic of Cuba and its people for such a historic visit. Also, to take this opportunity to thank the Namibian government, represented here by our head of state, His Excellency Comrade Dr. Hart Gegob, President of the Republic of Namibia, for organizing this visit of our Cuban brothers to pay the cottage call to me here at the Tunda Trust Farm. Similarly, I wish to thank all the comrades and friends who came to attend this welcoming event, including the Army Commander Major General Thomas Lokoujo, Kambira, accompanied by the veterans of the liberation struggle, particularly those who participated in the decisive battle of Kwitupana Valley. I'm also grateful that the Commissioner of the National Youth Service is here, and also those present at this event, in order to express our solidarity with our Cuban revolutionary brothers. Director of Ceremonies, Namibia and Cuba share a long history of friendship and enjoy strong bond of solidarity, which dates back since the early 60s, when we were waging our liberation struggle to free ourselves from the yoke of colonial occupation and the foreign subjugation. We salute the selfless contribution of the Cuban people to self-determination and national liberation and the international solidarity. Did the revolutionary people of Cuba had been the source of immense inspiration to the people of Namibia during our difficult years for the struggle for national liberation under the leadership of SWAPO. It was through the wise and able leadership of Commandant Fidel Castro Ruzo that the revolutionary people of Cuba rendered all around the political, diplomatic, and material support to the struggling people of Latin America, Africa, and Asia to attain their freedom and genuine independence. Let's not forget, Cuba's foreign policy was voicing its strong stance against the apartheid white minority regime of South Africa at the international forum. Most significantly, the Cuban role in Angola remains an unshakable memory in the lives of our people when the combined Angola FAPLA forces with the Cuban international forces and the combatants of the People's Liberation Army Namibia swaps military wing. In one of the decisive turning points in Southern Africa history, brought to the white minority regime for South Africa to its knees when it suffered a heavy military defeat at the Battle of Kwetsupanabale. Indeed, the enemy war machinery was broken and its soldiers demoralized. As a result, in February 1989, P.W. Botha suffered a stroke as his political demise was inevitable with the independence of Namibia on the 21st March 1999. And the British of power to the majority government of the ANC in South Africa in April 1994. Against this background, the entire Southern Africa region and the people of Namibia in particular will forever remain indebted to the revolutionary people of Cuba for the unparalleled role they played in the total liberation of the African continent. The Cuban people not only shared the same treasures with us, but also sacrificed their lives for the just cause of our freedom and genuine independence. As you are aware, after the barbaric attack on Kasinga refugee came on the 4th of May 1978, in which more than 1,000 Namibians lost their lives, it was the Cuban international forces that repelled the colonial South African troops of occupation and managed to take hundreds of our people to safety. The children who survived the Kasinga massacre were taken to Cuba. Two schools were established at the island of Youth, where thousands of young Namibians were educated at the Hendrik Witbooi and Hosea Kutako High School, as well as other institutions of higher learning in the Republic of Cuba. In this regard, the Cuban Revolution has contributed immensely to build the capacity of our human capital, especially in the fields of health, education, agriculture, sports, and among others. And they remain an exemplary school and an inexhaustible source of inspiration to progressive forces the world over. We continue to pay our humble respect to the Cuban internationalists who laid their precious lives for the just cause of our freedom and genuine independence. And we never forget their sacrifice. Director of Ceremonies, this is my hope and expectation that the release of the Cuban Five will be the first step towards the long-awaited end of the economic blockade against the Republic of Cuba and the normalization of the relationship between the two countries. In conclusion, consistent with the extraordinary Cuban tradition of international solidarity, we will continue to render our support and solidarity to the revolutionary people of the Republic of Cuba. Long live the revolutionary people of Cuba. Long live the Republic of Namibia.